Have you ever wondered how to build a rocket from scratch?
No kits, no instructions, no easy snap-together parts.
If you've ever dreamed of doing this, you're in the right place. This is How to Build a Rocket from Scratch. Let's start with the basics, the parts of a rocket. When designing your rocket, you will need nose cone, shock cord, recovery system, fins, body tube, launch lug, engine mount, popcorn, and dinosaurs. Okay, just kidding on the popcorn and dinosaurs, but snacks are always a great idea. There's a lot that goes into building a rocket. All these pieces come together to make the perfect flight. Let's start at the top, literally. The nose cone is at the top of the rocket. It improves aerodynamics of your rocket to help you reach higher altitudes. There are three main types of nose cones: conical, ogive, and parabolic. Drag decreases with each shape.
What is drag?
Drag is the aerodynamic force that opposes an aircraft's motion through the air. So, less drag means less opposition and higher altitudes. Teacher tips. Nose cones should always be made of plastic or wood, never metal. Tip number two. They should fit snugly into the body tube, so the recovery system can easily eject.
So what happens when your rocket launches and the nose cone pops off? Is it just lost forever in the forbidden forest?
Nope. This is why we have a shock cord. The shock cord attaches the nose cone to the body tube. Their elastic nature absorbs shock when the recovery system deploys and ensures your rocket stays together. So fun. I don't know why. I've mentioned the recovery system a few times now.
Yeah, what is that?
A recovery system is a device inside a model rocket for the purpose of returning it to the ground safely. Essentially, you want your rocket to land gently, not like a dart. This is why nose cones are made of plastic. There are many types of recovery systems. For example, a parachute, streamer, glider, helicopter, and more. Parachutes and streamers are the most common type. They either attach to the nose cone or the shock cord. Teacher tips. Tip number one, be sure you have the right size recovery system for your rocket. Bigger rocket, bigger recovery system. Tip number two, watch our How to Fold a Parachute video for more information on parachutes. Link in the description below. Body tubes are the main portion of the rocket. They contain the payload, the engine, recovery wadding, and a recovery system. They are made of paper, and they come in varying sizes. You can make one yourself, but it's better to buy one so you know you can easily find a nose cone to fit. You can use a tube cutting guide to cut your body tube to any length you desire. Link in the description below for more information on tube cutting guides.
What if I want my rocket to be longer?
No worries. You can attach body tubes together using a tube coupler, which attaches body tubes of the same diameter. It's a fun noise. Or an adapter, which connects body tubes of different diameters. That one doesn't make the noise, so it's really less exciting, but they're connected, so. The payload section allows you to include anything you want in your rocket. Things like an altimeter for science, an egg for an egg drop competition, popcorn for a snack later when it lands. It's a great idea. Or anything else you want. You can get creative. be sure your payload section is big enough to hold your payload and any necessary protection. It's important to consider the weight of your payload when developing your design. Teacher tips. Tip number one, if you don't have a tube cutting guide, you can make one using tape. Tip number two, if your cut doesn't come out straight, you can use a sanding block to smooth out the edges. If you create a payload section, be sure to tape instead of glue so you can get your payload out after the flight, especially if it's a buttery snack like popcorn. It's important to consider how you will connect your rocket to the launch pad. A launch lug is a great place to start. It's a small paper tube that attaches to your body tube. During the first few moments of flight, the launch lug slides on the launch rod to help guide the rocket straight until the rocket is moving fast enough for the fins to take over and guide the rocket. Teacher tips. Tip number one, a bigger, heavier, or longer rocket will require a launch rod with a bigger diameter, thus requiring a bigger launch lug. Tip number two, glue your launch lug on straight so it's parallel with the body tube. Use an engine mount.
What is that?
It holds the engine inside the body tube. Pick an engine and build the mount that will fit. An engine hook or a plastic retainer cap will hold the engine inside the mount. Oh, is it time for teacher tips? Tip number one, be sure to use enough glue so the centering rings are nice and tight. Tip number two, be sure to test fit the engine mount inside the body tube before you glue to make sure it fits correctly. Tip number three, use the correct glue. Wood glue is perfect for paper to paper joints, and plastic cement is great for plastic to paper. Okay, let's move on to fins.
Fins? Like for a fish? I forget. What do these do?
Fins provide stability for your rocket once it flies off the launch pad. This stability ensures that your rocket flies on a predictable path, making it very safe. The root edge of the fin connects to the body tube, and the leading edge is on top towards the sky. The grain of the wood should follow the leading edge.
So can I have 12 fins?
Typically, rockets have 3 to 4 fins. A fin alignment template is very helpful to ensure that you align your fins correctly. A link to that template is in the description below. Fins are typically made of balsa or plywood. There are many different shapes you can choose from. If you want to reach a higher altitude, round the edges of your fins and make them smaller. If you need to decrease the maximum altitude of your rocket, increase the fin size. Teacher tips. Tip number one, attach the fins securely by adding glue fillets to both sides of the root edge of every fin. Tip number two, let the fins dry by placing the body tube upside down. Safety equals stability. Say it with me. Safety equals stability. Safety equals stability. You want to make sure your rocket is stable.
I've only used a kit where I knew the rocket was going to be stable. So how do I know if it's going to be stable?
There are a few different ways you can check stability. You can measure the center of pressure and center of gravity. You could do a swing test, complete math equations, or use a rocket simulator. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, that's okay. Be sure to watch our How to Fly with Stability video, link below. If you determine that your rocket is not stable, here are a few adjustments you can make. Increase the fin size or number of fins, increase body tube length, or add weight to your nose cone. Again, check out our stability video for a lot more in-depth info. Well, there you have it. The basics of building a rocket from scratch. So you can go from this to this. Thanks for watching How to Build a Rocket from Scratch. Thanks for watching with Estes Education. If you like this video, be sure to like, subscribe, and hit the bell to be alerted for new content. We'll see you soon!